Because her description says she does the same thing, how she like leans in, how he leans into you, she does the same thing. I don't know, that's what I was saying to Brian, when you guys were all out walking, you were talking about it, I said, it's just the weirdest thing, like, it's unusual for one dog, but two dogs to be like so much like that. Right? That's kind of what it seems like almost. Yeah, it's a little weird. Such a weird dog.
Yeah.
And her description reads the same way. So call this up. So, I was saying, what I'll do next week is if one of them moves. Cause I'm surprised that he's worked out in adoption. Because he's got a great personality.
He's really good on leash.
Yeah, so if one of them leaves, or both of them for that matter, if those two are for her, then both back up. If she's anything like him, it'd be super chill and easy.
Yeah. What about that dog that went up April a lot with the iris?
I believe she is not. I remember looking at them.
Kind of went out to put it back.
So she had come, I can't bring her up, she was like, she was one, she was part of a pair, wasn't she, Iris and?
Yes, yes.
Okay, so the other one I could bring up, but I couldn't bring her, so that's why I never brought them. I knew there was something with that, because a bunch of the volunteers didn't even prep, so I can't bring her up. So, she likes to dig, likes to jump 5-foot block wall, has escaped 12 times, that was long in June of this year. She resource guards the person, fatally injured cat.
Wow.
Destructive and rapid return for property damage.
Who's that?
Severe separation anxiety, if I remember correctly.
Oh my goodness.
She checks all the boxes.
Not the good ones, but yeah.
I'm surprised she's not on the E list.
She may find herself on it now.
Where is my dog because of you? I don't know if you saw it in the hobby. Oh my god, he was so cute. That's the dog's name because he just jumps around with a coffee bean. He's just so much energy.
Right.
It was so cute. He's chasing this little thing around the concrete floor and he's jumping up and he was super cute.
I think a lot of those, they would do more videos. I think they'd get more of those dogs. Fine for the cute little easy to adopt dogs.
Yeah.
You know, like those, just a cute picture is fine. But the dogs that are harder to adopt, you know, video that shows them beyond just being a picture, I think that stuff from the site work is more beneficial to the dog.
Josh is like, what's in there exactly? I think, can I pick what I like? Well, I've put in his records and I put a note in his notes that says that he was labeled this and or he was named this and why.
Right.
So that's what I did. So one of my kids is going to get an earful for me later today. So I write dates on everything that I open and put in my refrigerator. So like food containers, if fast food, you know, like not fast food, like leftovers from somewhere. So when I come home, I always write the date on it because sometimes I think, oh, that was just 2 days ago. And then I think about, oh dear God, that was like 11 days ago.
Yeah.
In the garden. Oh. So I date everything. When I cook something, leftovers, same thing. I always write it in Sharpie. And then when I go to, if it's a container that I'm keeping, then I want to go clean it. I just color it and just scribble over it with a dry erase.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, and then I'm starting my Sharpie from the side of my refrigerator. Oh,
thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Talk about adoption stickers.
Yeah, actually, 27 since we opened our doors here, either adopted or fostered.
I'm sorry,
I'm recognized here. That was from Laura. So this is what I have left. Laura came in and got 20.
Good.
And then Cindy got, I think she got 10.
Okay.
Yeah. Great. That's who it was. We were talking and there was somebody, it's Cindy, yeah, so she's one of my Friday volunteers. Yeah. So she was saying that she's doing, Cindy was planning on putting them on, like, up on this end of town, there's a bright green sign that say, Golden Eagle.
Oh, yes, right on those golden eagles.
Yeah, so she said she was planning to use them to put them right over the phone number.
Uh-huh. I love it. Because signs torn down are awesome, but signs left with, and then every time
it sends a message not only to people who see them, but to the person who owns those signs. And it's got to be somebody up on this end of town because they're always up. Do you remember seeing them when we were up at Longcanto?
Yeah.
They'd always be like at those intersections. It's like Grant Craig up in the center of the neighborhood. Because I come north on the cross. And they put them up high. That's the thing, too. They're not easy to, like, I don't think I'd be able to reach them to tear them down.
You need a ladder.
Yeah. Yep.
That's mean.
But you can see them. You can see one on the other side of the road, like coming southbound on Craycroft. And then what else do I see? I think up at, I'm thinking we're still at Longentada. I think right at the intersection up there by Longentada too, at Campbell and Skyline. So they know where to hit them. They go where the people
go. Go where the money. Go where the money is.
Absolutely.
Yeah. They might be breeding a picture axe, but they're selling it.
Exactly.
Yeah. And Duke is no longer at risk today.
What's that?
Duke is no longer at risk today. They halted.
I don't know. I don't follow that stuff through the day at all. I don't know. I'm assuming so. They're down close enough to there should be no reason. So, private volunteers and staff. I said, well, actually, the one adoption that we had today didn't register properly on their system. I said, so technically, we hit 450 because it was 451 last night.
Oh.
Like, it's technically 450 because CJ didn't count for whatever reason. It didn't show up properly in their thing. So
they are 450.
They were 450 as of last night. As of close of business, they were technically
as long as they didn't take any more than
that's the thing. They have an excellent day. They get 50 or more dogs out, and they have 70 come in the back door. It's like,
or hoarding case.
Yeah, or hoarding case. But you know what's really cool about that now is now that they have the mobile medical unit, the MMU, they're not bringing in as many hoarding cases because what they're doing now is they're starting to go out to those hoarders and they're altering, which isn't fixing it.
Awesome.
But it means that they can't breed it. So that's a big deal. Because you know that they're there, they can go out there periodically, maybe every few months to do kind of brief checkups, and whoever needs medical stuff. I mean, that's the way to do it. Rather than bring them in, especially as long as you can figure out this in the county and have a so ridiculous overcrowd. Because that's the thing, you're bringing in dogs. You bring in a 40-dog hoarding case, and now you're going to kill dogs that have been at the shelter trying to find homes. That's not fair to those dogs. It's not their fault that some hoarder has 50 dogs out there. It's kind of the idea of the CNR thing for cats. Right? It's a similar thing. Now if you can't do that with dogs, you can't have the dogs. But in a hoarding case, it's a similar, do what you can to fix them in the field and let them stay there.
Just stop the increasing numbers.
Yep. Because that's the thing. And I think most hoarders start out with good intentions. You know, they want to save them, they want to do right, but they know a dog that's in a bad situation and they take them. But when nobody's altered, then that creates an entirely new problem. Yeah.
And who doesn't want to say that he has
Well, that, and that's it, and I think that's the other part, is they wanna do the right thing, but then they become financially, just to feed them, they're overwhelmed, you know?
I mean, you've been medical, yeah. It's your.
Mm-hmm, not about to get it for, no, be fifty odd and take care of medical and all that, no, absolutely not. So, yeah, I think that's going to have, and the funny thing is when they told me they were getting it, I truthfully didn't think anything about the idea of using it in affordable situations, but it's kind of brilliant.
Yeah.
You know?
Somebody take that side of the box.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, they started working, they started partnering with some of the county's mental health organizations, because more often than not, the hoarding behavior is tied to mental illness. And so they can come and clear all the dogs or all the cats, and 6 months later, they're gonna have a house full again. It's something that goes beyond wanting to help animals. It's something more than that. And so acknowledging that and understanding it.
And they all deserve this to help animals.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. So it's, you know, people have a lot to say about PAC, and they're not perfect, but they get it so much more right than most municipal shelters in the country. They just do.
A lot of problems.
And what I've always loved about PAC and why I've been involved for so long is that they try to come at it from so many different angles. It's not just a, oh, this is how we can walk, this is how we're going to do it. They really do try to kind of step back and get a different perspective and, you know, try to come at it from a different angle.
Well, and I know still on Facebook, they're being very transparent.
Yes.
They're putting these questions up that I'm sure have been asked, and they're trying to know the answer, and they're coming from them.
Mm-hmm. Well, and that's the thing, and, you know, when the lady called me about what happened with community society last month, she said, well, what do you think is the one thing that they need to do? I said, they need to take a page from the tax rules and make themselves transparent. I said, nobody trusts them because they have hidden behind, for the last 20 years, they've hidden behind their files. That's not acceptable. You want my money? I want to know where it's going. I want to know how you're using it. And now they've got, and it's the only reason, it's kind of disgusting, but it's the only reason that they're going to make changes, because they got busted.
Mm-hmm.
And it hit them in the wallet, and now they're going to have to make changes. But at the end of the day, if that's what it took to make it happen, then something good can come out. And I think if they do it right, they can find a partner with PAC, and they can truly change the face of animal welfare. You know, they could become a national model for other states.
And they still charge you to take a stray with?
Yep.
See, I think that's ridiculous.
They charge you to take a stray, and then they charge the... Can you maybe even know which cities? So, I remember years ago, she had a foster dog through one of the local rescues. The dog had gotten out. It was back when they were still down in Kelvin. The dog wasn't gone 40 minutes, somebody found him and took him down the street to. She had left him in the house. Totally innocent thing. He was microchipped. His license was up to date. He was current. He had all of his stuff, everything, okay? He wasn't there 45 minutes. She went to get him. That was 10 minutes.
Oh, my.
Well, what? They charged the person that dropped him off.
Right.
He wasn't even there long enough to be fed. He got water. $267. So she contacted the rescue director, who called over there, and they said, too bad, you shouldn't have been letting him roam the street. She had it on her video, because she's got, you know, she had a camera. She looked like just a piece of giant oracle. She had cameras all over her property. Yeah.
I mean, it happens. Dogs get out.
She went in with the digital recording. And she said, you can see exactly what time it was when he popped the wall. He was picked up almost immediately and taken over. He wasn't at the Humane Society 4 minutes. And she didn't have the money, and they wouldn't work with the rescue. They said, no, we're not waiving any cash.
So happened?
They had a dog.
Oh, man.
And he was a pity. Like, you needed another one?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
So it's just all about the money.
It has nothing, yeah. And that's the thing.
That's horrible.
So, it's unfortunate that the things that have happened over there, but I think it was going to take something like that, some big shakeup like what has happened,
mm-hmm.
for things to change. So I'm hoping that they'll do it, not just talk about it.